from this topic coordinate geometry, and within this about the lines, as you can see that the equation of the lines are given, and further we need to find out the area bounded by the regions. This means the last point implies that we are dealing with the first quadrant. So we have x part more than 0, this is y part more than 0. The first inequality x plus cy less than or equal to 9, that means if let us say we have this as x is equal to 0, y is equal to 3. Clearly by observation we can say that x is equal to 0, y is equal to 3. The other part is we can take x is 9, y is 0. So we just have to take 2 points, that will be more than enough, and we can say that this is where we are looking at. So if let us say so that's what is x plus 3y is less than or equal to 9 is the equation. X plus 3y equal to 9 is the equation of this line. But when it says that x plus 3y is less than or equal to 9, that means we are dealing with this entire area, this particular area. But this is already, it should be more than this part, it should be more than this part. So essentially, we are dealing with this point, this entire shaded region. But there is another point here, that there is another line which is to be drawn. 3x plus y is less than or equal to 9. So that means x should be equal to 3 somewhere over here, midpoint. And the other one is y is equal to somewhere about 0. So this is, we have x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 9. Now we got to connect this. So now when we connect this part, so this is the equation, this line, this is the equation for 3x plus y equal to 9. But what we are looking for, 3x plus y is less than or equal to 9. So that means the all this is going to be lesser than or equal to. So this is the portion. So what the question says that when we have drawn this line, when we have drawn this line, where exactly in which portion they are meeting? So when we say that which portion they are meeting, essentially we are looking for this portion. This is that particular region, as you can see that where they are meeting. And this portion is what we got to find out the area. So if one has really solved this particular kind of the question earlier on, it will not be a difficult task to really tackle it during the exam time. But if you are doing it for the first time and that too during the test time, it can really be slightly more taxing. But nevertheless, we will see a way out for this. So after that, we have this 3, 0. Let us proceed further on this. So proceeding further on this, what we have, this is anyway 0, 0. And this is one point which you got to solve for it. And you have altogether, this is the entire quadrilateral. Now, when you solve for this, you'll find that there are two equations. So just eliminate for y or maybe eliminate for x. It's symmetric altogether. So what we get, 3x plus y is equal to x plus 3y. That means x is equal to y essentially. If x is equal to y, we get 4y is equal to 9, y is equal to 9 by 4. So I have 9 by 4 and this is also equal to 9 by 4. At this stage, there are many methods by which you can proceed and find out the area. Method number one. Now, in a scenario like this, if we drop this perpendicular, then we can see that this is one part, a trapezium for which you can find out the area of the trapezium, and then this is the area of the triangle. And area of the triangle can be obtained by taking half base into height. So we know this height here, which is 9 by 4, and this also we know, which is 9 by 4. So that is one method we have. Now, the another method which is more robust in nature, and which is more about in terms of whatever may be the coordinates over here, and which is the key idea behind the coordinate geometry, and which is the area part. If let us say I have, this is x1, y1, this is x2, y2, this is x3, y3, this is x4, y4. So we say that the area is governed like this, half, and for quadrilateral, pentagon, etc., etc., we can solve it. So half, this is x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3, there will be four coordinates again, x4, y4 back to x1, y1. So this is something which will take care of any kind of the coordinates which might be there. And that way the task becomes a lot easier. Now what we have to do here, so while the first method is something which we can actually go ahead during the test time and then can simplify, this is another one from the point of view of building our skill sets, our learning. So continuing further, this is half x1, y1. This is 0, 0. x2, y2 is 0, 3. This one is 9 by 4. 9 by 4, this is 3, 0, and finally 0, 0. So the way we actually simplify is like this. We take this particular group, again we take this group, again we take this group, again we take this group. So when we take a particular group like this, it's like 0 into 3 minus 0, easy, 0. Next one is 0 into 9 by 4 is 0, minus this number, minus 3 into 9 by 4, which makes it as half. We got to be very careful with the sign, minus 27 by 4. Again, the next part is this into this is 0, this is again minus 27 by 4, so this is minus 27 by 4. Last part is this group, so 3 into 0 is 0, this is 0, so this entire portion is what we got to simplify. So we can see that once we do that, we get 27 by 2. Modulus sign indicates we have to take the positive value. So 27 by 2 multiplied by 1 by 2, which makes it as 27 by 4. So this is the answer which you have to mark when it comes to this question, which is like, what is the area of the area which is bounded? So this is one point which you got to remember. In case if you have, let's say, maybe a polygon with, let's say, 5 points which are given, then what you have to do, friends, x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y4, x4, y4, x5, y5, and then back to x1, y1. Hexagon with 6 points, x6, x7, x8, and so on. And then the task is that's how you really go about solving the question. Thanks for watching this particular video.